Just missile program, an experienced army. If the U.S. engages in a military clash with Iran, it could be costly.
This will not be like our actions in Iraq, in Afghanistan, or in Syria. This is a conflict on an entirely different scale with a highly sophisticated, well-trained, and well-armed adversary.
An adversary that would almost certainly turn to guerrilla tactics early on. Military analysts say Iran could stage attacks such as those last year on tankers in the Strait of Hormuz and Saudi oil fields. The U.S. blamed Iran for those hits. Iran denied it, but world oil markets were briefly rocked nonetheless, and bigger attacks could undeniably create larger shocks. Or Iran could call on its many allies in the region to carry its fight against America. Shia militias, Hezbollah, Hamas, the Houthis, groups that could use Iranian intelligence, logistics, weapons, and more to launch terror strikes on U.S. allies, embassies, military bases, American officials, or even private citizens abroad or at home.
There is a network of Iranian elements within the United States that the FBI is watching.
In terms of sheer firepower, Iran is no match for the U.S., which has more warships, planes, helicopters, tanks, and active troops.
They know that if we go all the way up the escalation ladder, you know, our capabilities, our air force, our naval capabilities will destroy theirs. They're much happier playing at a lower level, sort of the asymmetric level.
But when and how and aimed at which targets? All we know for sure is that the Iranians are promising a response to the killing of that top-level military leader.
Definitely there will be a revenge. There will be a harsh revenge. Iran will act based on its own choosing.
And the White House?
We will respond with great force and great vigor if the Iranian leadership makes a bad decision.